If you were watching my channel in 2K20, you know that I used a slashing playmaker, a 6'4 slashing playmaker with sharp take for the majority of the year. All right. It wasn't until the end of the year that I started playing stage that I made a BP build because the quick draw was just unmatched. Hall of Fame quick draw is way better than gold quick draw in 20. All right. In a stage, you're not going to be able to get off much shots with gold, you know, quick draw if you're killing for the threes more than the twos. But we made it work, right? Unfortunately, this year, the game, you know, the developers just decided, you know what, we're just going to make one guard build really the best guard build, and there's none equal to it. You know, when it comes to everything a play shot can do, a play shot can ISO, a play shot can use screens, a play shot can play defense. It's just the best guard build out there. The pie chart is unmatched, right? Now, this is the toughest thing to do this year because using a slash and playmaker, it's tough when you take in consideration the fact that, look at this right here, they nerf slash and playmakers so they don't get anything above like a 70 some dunk, right? Unless you sacrifice your three ball. If you remember on 2K20, you had elite contact dunks on a slash and playmaker at 99. Elite. All right. You can shoot the three ball from half court if you were a good enough shooter consistently. Unfortunately, look at this. This is what they do to any other build that's not a play shot. They played the build so bad, man. All right. To where this year you can't make any mistakes. And my boy Sean, you know, he was on Twitter basically saying the same thing. Like, this year the three hunt is so easy. This year every guard is so golden because it's the easiest 2K, right? All you gotta do is speed glitch to a three. If the three's not there, hit the slip, showtime, you're gonna get takeover, and then you're not gonna miss anything unless they just double you and you can't dribble, right? But you have us, you know, that's trying to be different, trying to have fun, trying to not do what everybody else is doing with a slash and playmaker, right? Now you got to take in fact that this one, 2K21 current gen, is one of the most buggiest games, not even just current gen, next gen, one of the most buggiest versions of 2K ever. You can't shoot, you can't play without getting a lag chop every other second, right? And it's only 2K that this happens in, if you notice this. When I play Call of Duty, none of this not happen. You see? Dog, can't play upon 4K. And none of this not guan. All right? I'm going to get good, optimized gameplay. But unfortunately, with 2K, that's just not the case. Why? They don't have no competitive, so... No competitors, so they're just chilling back with their feet up, bro. They don't care. They drop their game just like they're gonna drop 2K22. And if it's not properly optimized for next gen, dude, they're not gonna care. They're gonna take 3 months to fix it. You know why? Guess why? Because they're making their money regardless. All right, they're making their money regardless. So why do they care about people like you and me that want to have fun if they're gonna get paid? And it's not even, to me, it's not even really about the developers or anything like that. To me, it's about who's in charge. You know, you got the CEOs, you got, you know, of Take-Two, you got all that stuff, that those are the ones really calling the shots. Everybody else are just puppets. But I do feel like the developers have a huge say-so in the gameplay, because I don't think that the CEO really cares about no gameplay, right? They don't know what speed glitch is. They don't know what none of that is, man. They just say, make a good basketball game. Here's some money to make it. Here's the resources you need to make it so you can get my pockets bigger, right? Unfortunately, you know, 2K20, when it came to that, was a success, but the same neighborhood was a killer. So what did they do? They gave us a different, you know, setting and just ruined the builds. It's like every year, Agent said it a while back, man, years ago. It's like every year 2K gives you something and takes something away that you like, so they can bring it back the next year and take away something else. So it's like they keep that cycle going so they can keep their game selling, you know, to the top, right? Because we didn't like 99. I'm not going to say me, but a lot of people didn't like 99. Road to 99, so they took it out. But what did they do? Yeah, they gave us a new, you know, builder and stuff. But they gave us the same neighborhood with different seasons. They couldn't even change the color of the courts, bro. They couldn't even change the whole platform. Like, I know it doesn't take that much work to do that, bro. I'm telling you it doesn't. I know it doesn't, man. You can give us a freaking blacktop that you got. You got freaking blacktops that are modded, right? On PC users giving us the best courts, man, right? And you telling me $1 billion company can't do that? Nah. All I'm saying is this, man. this is the toughest thing to do this year, probably. It's to go to the stage with a slashing playmaker. When you take everything else in note, if I really want to have fun and dominate and win 99% of the games, right? I go to the stage, I ISO with my scoring machine. Why? Because they're not going to be able to stop me on the three hunt. Y'all seen what the scoring machine can do. The scoring machine is the next best thing compared to a play shot. And you get a 75 dunk. On if you want to sacrifice your three ball, you can get up to an 80 dunk, right? Which, I ain't going to lie, if I would have done that, that probably would have been too nasty, man. Because I would have been able to freaking... Bro, I would have been able to get straight arm tomahawks and those type of dunks, right? But I wanted that high three ball because I don't want to come out here with no 88 three ball, bro. Even though that's goated, it's still not going to compare to those play shots with a 95 three ball, all right? You need something close to it in the 90s to really just three hunt with a play shot. But the only bad thing about a scoring machine is it's gold playmaking. So you're going to get ripped here and there. You're going to run out of stamina faster because guess what? It's gold handles for days. Your quick first step is not going to be as deadly as a play shot because it's gold quick first step. Unpluckable, bro, I'm telling you, man. A scoring machine is good and all, but nothing compares to Hall of Fame playmaking, right? You see, I'm dribbling and I'm standing with a green because my stamina's not ran out. If I was on a scoring machine doing all that, the possibilities are I'd have to have double Gatorade in every category because I was going to be out of stamina. Y'all seen it in the gameplays. Now, this right here is what really pissed me off, man. We was flooding these dudes, bro, on a slashing playmaker, a two-way shot creator, and a perimeter defender. Flooding them. And they got everything going their way at first. And we was flooding them, bro. But you know what? It came down to is literally just what I keep telling y'all. It's just hard to use a slashing playmaker, man, because you can make mistakes here and there, bro. But unfortunately, if you make too much mistakes on this build, it's not like you can come down and say, I'm going to get the three easily on the ISO. Because guess what? The more mistakes you make, the more your three ball drops. Fortunately, we only have about a little over a month before NBA 2K22 comes out. So we don't have to deal with this anymore. But I've been literally trying to, you know, be different, trying to do new builds, you know, all this different stuff. So, you know, I can really see, did 2K really do anything to help us? Did it leave anything on the table? Unfortunately, they didn't. All right. It's going to take skill to win in the stage with a slashing playmaker. I'm telling you that right now, because you can get the two all game you want. But if you can't three hunt with a play shot and match that, you're done for, bro. I'm telling you, especially in the stage, bro, because while you're just dunking and dunking and dunking, the other guard is getting showtime done for them every single time. And they're going to get, look at me, drunk dribbling. Bro, the last couple days I've been down so bad. I know you're like, bro, what? I had to just basically re-upload this video, man, because one of the tracks that I use that, you know, I got permission from a YouTuber that creates songs, written permission, somebody copyrighted it and they don't even own rights to the song. It's crazy, man. Not only that, dude, I'm telling y'all, y'all don't believe me, look at the screen. I went from having 860 to 900 Mbps, you know, playing the game, to look where it's at right now. 55.5, bro. 55.5. And I was like, man, why do I feel so delayed compared to what I'm used to playing on, bro? And it was because of that. And it's still going on because this video, the reason why this upload is so late is because this video took an hour and a half to render. Not render, but upload. Which is crazy because it regularly takes only 6 minutes to upload a video from me. So bear with me. I'm gonna have a technician coming over tomorrow to fix this problem ASAP, bro. Because time is money. And this upload should have been out at 7 o'clock. But you know how down bad I am? It took an hour and a half to upload. And then when it uploaded, there was a copyright strike. But guess what? I'm still pushing. I'm still going, bro. I could have the excuse to be like, man, I'm not going to upload. It's already 9:30 where I'm at. 9:38 right now. And the video should have been out 2 hours ago. I could have been saying all that, man. But I've been trying this whole time to fix this situation myself. And you know what? I was able to fix it for the time being, but I don't even think I'm going to be able to run. Now, look at this right here. Look at that lag spike, bro. On the game winner. 2K's the only game I know that does this, bro. Call of Duty does not do that, man. Anyways, we don't have to worry about this game too much longer because 2K22 is right around the corner. Yazid, big up on yourself, big up Lord Almighty. What doesn't count to nothing at all. I'm trying to get this internet fixed. I'm trying to get this upload time, you know, upload speed fixed, because that's what I have to use to stream. And if it's trash, I can't stream. I was going to stream 2 days ago, but the upload speed was so bad that I was like, you know what? This is not going to even be a good experience. So hopefully after tomorrow or whenever the technician comes, it'll be good.